Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to another episode of the BattleTech Backer Beta. So, in my last episode, I announced that I wanted to try out multi-target, but it didn't really come into play. I was focused on so many other things as well, and therefore I'm dedicating an episode completely to multi-target. And as you might tell, I have two of the pilots with multi-target. I've got Kraken and Wildfire, and multi-target does exactly what you'd expect. You can target up to three different targets and shoot your weapons to these targets and maximizing your damage output and your to-hit chance with that. And this is what we are going to do. Also, I'm choosing the Orion 4 for the max for them, because the Orion has just a shitload of weapons. So we can just utilize this chassis here, because we have the weapons to select multiple targets, and it is a very durable mech as well. I'm choosing the Kintaro with Paradise as the pilot, as my medium mech here, and I've got a Panther with a Witness, and Witness has the Sensor Lock skill. Where's Witness? Down here. Sensor lock means that, I'm removing the evasive skill from the enemy mech. And since we are playing against a heavy striker lance, and Paradise is in there, so it's I think, a good idea to have that one here. Also, I'm going to play on the big loch, or lock, on the rainy day. So let's get into it. Prepare for combat. Now, what I want to do is I want to bring my Orions to the front line. I want to either sit them and let them sit in cover or in the water, depending on how the enemy is moving. Water is good because of the heat dissipation, the cooling, because then I can just shoot all of my weapons over and over again, make great use of the multi-target, of course. And the woods, of course, will provide a bit of cover, which will result in a 25% damage reduction. So that's the basic plan here. I want to bring my Panther to some high ground, to a good Overwatch position, to make use of the sensor lock, of course. And my Kintaro is just my mobile striking force. Now, playing Big Loch. Big Loch is, as you can see, a lot of water. Playing on a rainy day here. I don't know if the weather is doing some heat management as well. It could be. But I don't know. Maybe rain is dissipating heat a bit more than like a sunny day or so. But again, I don't know that yet. So again, what I want to do is I want to bring my Orions to a good spot. So let's move them first, and then we are adapting the rest of the team. Enemy is starting from this spot. And I think we will meet somewhere around either in the woods here or on the left flank in the water. And actually, I don't think that I can get to the woods before the enemy does. So I think I'm going to the left here in the water. How might I help? This would be probably the best idea. Have no doubt it will be done. All right, Panther going over here. And I think I'm going to put my Panther on top of, like, this hill or this here to get, again, a good position to have an Overwatch. All right, let's see what's happening here. I really like this game. This is so cool. And I can't wait until the campaign comes out, until the multiplayer comes out. So the multiplayer has been postponed because of stability issues, which is perfectly fine, actually. I'd rather have a stable game to try than a game that is just frustrating me. And as a result, I think it's a good idea that they postponed the multiplayer. It's a bit of a shame because they announced it, and I announced taking part in the beta bash, the backer beta bash event, which I couldn't do then. But it's fine. But let's bring the Kintaro to the flank here. We can go to the woods, which is really nice. So we have the evasion on all of our mechs now, except for the Panther, but the Panther gets a little evasion bonus because of the jumps. So when you jump your jump jets, then it is tougher for the enemy to hit you. It's very important. So you can make use of that. And there comes the 35-ton mech. So that is the Jenna. Enemy Jenna coming in. And since he is the only target at the moment, I think we are just going to shoot him. Why not? I hear ya. So, Witness, can you jump up here? Yes, you can. So we are going to do this. I don't have line of sight, but I can use sensor lock anyway. Ooh, there they come. Okay, sensor lock on him. So he loses his evasive bonus now. And I've got sensor lock on him, so that means that I can fire my long-range missiles. But he's closing in anyway. Alright. So here comes the dodge, because I sprinted last turn, which is really good. But I got a head injury. Oh my god. Paradise. It's time to strike. Actually, maybe I can even bring the Jenna down right now. I'm not in his back here, indicated by the red part of the circle, so I would shoot his side. But this is a good spot. So let's go over here, let's twist ourselves like this. And maybe we can bring the Jenna down very easily here. As I mentioned earlier, the AI is not the best at the moment. It's really not the best. So this is kind of a suicidal move the Jenna did here. And our flanking attempt with Paradise, I think it paid off big time here. He's down already. Oh my god, this was so critical. Yeah, that is a big advantage, a huge advantage for my team here. Wow. Just one shot to the Jenna and he's down. So there's another mech incoming, a 60 tonner. 55. So that would be a quick draw and a griffin, if I remember correctly. No, it's a Kintaro, okay. So now we try to make use of the multi-target. I just want to show it to you. So we go over here. We can't get line of sight, though. Okay, that's a shame. But I can talk about some other stuff as well that is very interesting. So let's go over here. Already got a bit of stability damage on Wildfire here. But what's very interesting is that... wait a second. We can. I can show it to you later. Autocannons have a refire penalty. So when you shot your autocannon the round before, it gets a penalty for the next shot to hit. So it is kind of a recoil mechanic that they put in here. And I find it very interesting. So at the moment, I only get the target moved plus 4 modifier here, which is kind of tough to hit. And he is evasive at the moment. So it's very unlikely that I hit him. But anyway, I'm going to shoot everything here just to show you. Oh, that was actually a hit. Wow. All right. Yeah, and there's the dodge coming in from the evasive move. Okay, Kraken is doing the same, kind of. Position confirmed. So now he is obstructed by this little mountain here. And when you hover over the weapons, you can see that there are so many modifiers in the game. That you can, that you should consider. I should probably have looked at it before I have finished my move, but anyway. Let's do it again, because I got the heat. Why not? Why not shoot everything? Let's get some early damage in here. Alright. So there's the 80-ton mech coming in. There's the Victor. Alright. So first thing is, Witness needs to get rid of the Kintaro's evasion. So I'm going for another sensor lock here. Or am I? No, let's actually get rid of his sensor lock, his evasion, because I want to show you something. Sensor locked. Because I expect the Kintaro will be active in initiative turn 3 or 4. I need to check that. So he will be earlier than the Victor. Oh, that hurts. Okay, Paradise will shoot. Let's take advantage of the water, actually. So what I meant earlier is you can just click on a point to move and then hover over the enemy mech, and then you can see the hit chances on the lower right. So this would be a good spot to hit the enemy quick draw here. Let's do it like the, I don't know, this. I understand. To hit the quick draw, we have the best chances to destroy, or not to destroy, but to get some good hits in. And this is exactly what we are doing. Okay, I didn't target the Kintaro because he still had evasive, so make sure that you... don't hit them too much, or try to hit them when they are evasive. If you have better targets, then go for them. Ooh, Wildfire is getting knocked down now. Another head injury, that is the third here. And the head component is critical. Ooh. Oh no, she's not knocked down. Okay, she's only unsteady. Alright, Wildfire. So, what I want to show you now is the following. We got some good targets here. And I just want to bring her over here, I guess. And we have got some good chance to hit the Victor now, but the quick draw as well. So I'm going to split my fire. The LRM-15 has a good chance on the Victor here. I can fire the LRM on long range and the SRM on and the medium lasers and everything to the quick draw. So exactly this is what we are doing now. Moving over here. And we take the multi-target now. So what we do now is you click the targets that you want to target. I'm going to click all of them because I want to show you. We have A, B and C. And now you can cycle through your weapons. So whenever I click here, as you can see, it changes the target. So I don't want to target C because, again, he's still evasive. And also he's guarded, 50% damage reduction. So no thank you. That will result in nothing. Instead, I'm going to shoot my short-range weapons on the quick draw and the long-range weapons on the Victor. This is going to the B and the AC-10 as well. And as you can see, we got now the refire penalty. That makes it tougher to hit. But since he is a big target, target size minus 2, we have a 100% hit chance. And the rest will go to the A, to the quick draw. So let's try.
Split fire. Confirmed.
All right. So this is really good because now we applied some nice unsteady penalties here. And the quick draw is about to fall. So Kraken is doing kind of the same here, going over to here, 100% chance on the LRMs and the AC, and the SRMs and the medium lasers go to the quick draw. And I think this is a very strong mechanic, because then you can, especially with missiles, you can apply a lot of shake damage, stability damage here, and bring down multiple targets at the same time. So A and B, this goes to the B, AC-10 as well, and the medium laser and the SRMs to the quick draw. Boom, a lot of impacts here. All right. Got his left arm destroyed, some medium lasers down, which is really, really good. And both get knocked down. See that? That is so cool. Boom. Pilot injured. There they go. Now let's see what you bring on to the table here. Victor's going for jump, which makes it tougher to hit. But the evasive move from my Kintaro is coming in big time. Paradise is such a strong pilot. Just take any brawler in Paradise and just get close and you are fine. Because every time you move, you again get that nice bonus here. So, Sensor Lock does nothing against Guard, I guess? No, it does not. So, we can basically just stop Sensor Locking now and just shoot the enemy from our Overwatch position. And this is what we are doing. I could probably... should I jump once more? Again, jumping helps getting that nice modifier. Also, a height bonus, or height gives you a bonus for to hit. When you look at this. Come on. I just want to target somebody. Oh, I can't because I don't have line of sight. Okay, I'm going to show you. Let's go over here. Yeah, let's jump into a good high spot.
Taking the high road.
There we go. Oh, wait, this was not good because my PPC is now... anyway, 85% is still enough. But as you can see, we got a height difference. That guy gives us a minus one difficulty modifier, which is really nice. Target moved, plus 4. Again, keep that in mind. So I think I'm going to shoot you because you are knocked down and you are steady. And I think it's very easy to hit him now. So let's go for the center torso component. Because the center torso is almost breached, only 20 hit points there. So let's just bring him down this way. Ba-boom. So with all the modifiers in place, I think this game will be very strategic. So you have to think ahead where you want to be, where the enemy is coming from. Anticipate the movement and play smart with your movement and such. And this is really cool. I like this about the game a lot. Okay, is this going to be... Oh, he's going for the Panther. Why? He could have easily knocked over my Kraken here. Was it Kraken? No, Wildfire. So Wildfire is unsteady already, so a punch to Wildfire would have brought her down. Okay, so we want to back up a bit.
How might I help?
Oh no, Paradise is on the move. Okay, then we are going in, of course. We can probably get the Victor down. Or the Quick Draw. I think the Quick Draw is the better target. Quick draw is a bit squishier, and again, you always want to move with Paradise, even if it's just one square. Don't stay steady, because you want to make use of the evasive move as much as possible. Now, we don't fire the LRM, we fire everything else into the back of the pick draw. Maybe we can take him out. Probably won't be enough. Ah, but we got some serious damage in here. That's really good. Okay, and here comes the knockdown. Yeah, alright.
Can't take much more of that.
Another pilot injury for Wildfire. How many did she... 4 injuries already.
I'm hit.
Ooh, this is critical. This is very critical. So we need to stand up right now. We need to move. We need to get into another position, bring down the quick draw, and maybe some other targets as well. And yeah.
Right.
Let's get out of here. Let's get the hell out of here. Okay, I want to go over here. This is not the best chance for my LRM. 55% on here. Yeah, but we have multi-targets, so we can choose our targets. Let's go for it. Alright, so multi-target. Definitely want to bring down the quick draw, and I think the Kintaro as well. This is not the most efficient way to bring the max down. I should probably shoot the Victor more, but since I have still all of my 4 max and he is in a very bad shape, I'm going to do it this way. So, quick draw, first target, Alpha. Yeah, let's take it this way. We have a penalty for standing up again. So knocking down the opponents is so crucial. It is so, so good. We have a plus 5 modifier, which is really not the best. What we can't do is... No, we can't do it already. Is inspiring the pilot. It's not ready yet, so this would be, of course, my move now. But yeah, we are going to shoot the LRMs to the Kintaro and see what happens.
Engage in multiple targets.
Okay, got some good hits in here. Caused a bit of stability damage, but not too much, sadly.
Standing by.
All right, Kraken, you need to finish him now. Can we get another angle on him? This would be... Wait. Can't get over here. We have a hit chance on him. We have a hit chance on him. Okay. Yeah, let's do it this way.
Got it.
All right, Kraken. Multi-target, quick draw, and the Kintaro. How's the Victor doing? He's still so good. He only lost his arm. So I'm going for the squishier targets first. Going for B for the LRMs. The rest is going completely to the quick draw. We have the refire modifier again. Target moved, plus 2. Yeah, let's do it. And the LRMs flying to the Kintaro. Alright. So the quick draw fell over. Another pilot injury. And the Victor is going for melee now. Ow! 90 to the core. No, to the arm. And 10 to the structure. To the structure there. Ouch. Witness, do something. Come on. Can we bring him down? He is so critical already. And we can make called shots, shots now. However, I could just make him unsteady while firing my SRMs to the Kintaro. This is a really tough choice I have to make now. Should we go for the damage or should we go for the more tactical approach? I think I decide for the damage and I want to get the legs off. So we fire everything.
Commencing alpha.
Knockdown target, not even a problem. We destroy the left torso, not the leg. But that takes another medium laser out and I think some heat sinks. Yeah, one single heat sink and 2 jump jets. And he is going for paradise as well. Yeah, he really wants to knock him down now. It's not enough though. Alright, Paradise, you need to get out of this position. It's time to bring down the quick draw, and I'm going to position myself behind him now. Because, again, this is a very scary target. It is a very damaged target already. And I just want to finish the job here. I don't even need Inspire, because I already have such a big hit chance.
Firing.
And that should be it. Yes! Good job.
Minor damage, Commander.
Okay, that wasn't too scary, and we are still in a very good position now, because I think I shoot with Wildfire first, because she is already very injured, so let's use her damage. Oh no, we can shoot both, because we are both in the same initiative round here. So anyway, let's go for all of our weapons. We still have the heat, we go for multi-target, we shoot all of them. This one goes to the Kintaro, which is indirect fire plus 4. Ah, okay, so this is the penalty we get here. It's good to know.
Confirmed.
But this was a good one. And again, the combination of SRMs and LRMs with multi-target is really nice because you can deal massive stability damage here.
Standing by.
So I want to position myself. Actually, I want to fire directly. So I'm taking the shot to the right shoulder or the right side of the Victor now. I don't even care. I just stay here. LRMs go to Bravo, this one goes to Alpha, and we're ready to shoot.
Got it.
That should take out his side torso. Yes. And he should be unsteady now. Yeah, both are unsteady, which is again good. Some more hits and they will be knocked over, and then we can make some more cold shots. That completely missed. Alright. So it's a relatively small target with high ground. It's relatively tough to hit, even if he stood there. I could have probably jumped to another spot to increase the defensive bonus even more. But I think at this point there is no need for it. Okay, let's do it anyway. Let's jump over here. Just stay mobile, use the jump jets. We have a very good chance to hit the Victor again, and this is exactly what we are going to do. Because look at him, he's already so damaged. Okay, we are a bit hot at this point, so firing only the PPC or only the SRMs. I think I'm going for the SRMs because I want to bring him down, I want to knock him over. Therefore, missile damage.
Critical hit, Commander.
And he's knocked down. So now my Orions in the back can easily target him and hopefully, yeah, shoot him down. Yeah, he's going for a reverse. And he is guarded now. Guarded and entrenched. So what you can do is you can inspire the people, and I think you ignore guarded and entrenched then. Wait a second. Does it say here? I'm not sure. I think it was this way. Anyway, so Paradise is on the move. Paradise is going to go over here, and we are bringing down the Victor now. No, actually, no. Let's go for the Kintaro because he is unsteady. No, he's not unsteady because he entrenched there. Braced. Anyway, let's try to bring him down.
The target is confirmed.
Let's make him unsteady. Lots of damage. Mech shut down, but that's fine. I think it will be the last round anyway. So let's go for Kraken. Kraken's moving over here. How about this? 100% hit chance. All right, this is exactly what I want to do. All right, Kraken. Multi-target again, and we are going to shoot the LRMs to the Kintaro. And everything else to the Victoria. Actually, I want to shoot the SRMs to the Kintaro as well, which are not that easy. Okay, then we are doing it like this. I think it should be enough to bring him down, to knock him over. Now the problem that you're having when multi-targeting, you can't make call shots to knock down Max. This is what you can't do. He's not knocked down, not quite. Okay, no, I don't want to quit here. So we're doing the same again.
Confirmed.
Because the Victor is so damaged already. Look at this. I think we can afford doing this. AB, this is going to be, and we have the heat to fire. All right. All right, knockdown. I think the knockdown mechanic is so strong again. It is so strong. And now I'm just bullying with them. This it's kind of mean what I'm doing here. But anyway, so Paradise is getting shot because he is shut down. Very easy target now. It goes to the arms, which is not that big of a problem. But we're going to restart next turn. Let's do another jump over here. Stay mobile. Again, take the high ground. Get yourself the movement and the jump jet advantage. And then we are going to fire. Keep on firing. This is what you do. Ah, let's take down the Victor.
Right, Commander.
There we go. Santa Claus destroyed. That's it for the Victor. Now we've got a Kintaro, which is food, basically, because he needs to stand up. He is not that good of aim now. He is against 4 mechs, being alone, and he's already severely damaged. Going for a punch here against Paradise. Boom, left arm destroyed. Poor little Paradise. Alright, so we have to stand up. Oh, restart. But restart and standing up is...
I'm back up. Let's go.
Wait. Okay, he stood up and restarted, right? So he is able to shoot next turn again.
Standing by.
I guess so. Alright, we are very hot here with our Kraken. So let's go over here. Let's just shoot this.
Roger.
Bring down the Kintaro, and again, that's basically it. So maybe we are going to destroy him in this turn. We have the heat to shoot all of these weapons. That's good. Massive damage. We've got an ammo crit here. Maybe if we can provoke another critical hit to the ammo, then it will explode and, yeah, we'll deal massive damage to the component. Depending on how much ammo is left, of course. So, let's do it again. I really hope for an ammo crit, another ammo crit, because I really want to show it off to you. I've never experienced it so far on my own. But there goes the right torso. Okay, no more ammo there. There was the ammo inside, yeah, alright. Okay, witness, I think it's time to... Can we do the death from above? No, we can't do it, sadly. Oh, yeah, we can. Okay, and let's do it. Death from above! Maybe it's just enough to bring him down. He's knocked down, but it wasn't enough to destroy him. Alright. Got a bit of lag damage now for my Panther, but it's fine. So, what is he going to do? Another headbutt. But I think he missed. Oh no, he hit. Unsteady, okay. So, Paradise.
Yes, Commander.
Punch him. Punch him! There we go! Hit to the Santa Torso. Mission successful. And that's it. Alright. Very nice. Very nice round here. I dominated the enemy pretty hard because of all of the knockdown. But as you could see, multi-target is very strong, especially if you have a combination of close-range and long-range weapons. Because then you can shoot your LRMs to the targets that are sitting behind. You can knock the enemy over multiple times and you can make use of all of your missile weapons to bring down these knockdowns and provoke the enemy. To miss a lot, to get call shots and such. And yeah, I think this is really strong and I'm very much looking forward using this ability with custom builds in the max. And yeah, I'm really looking forward for the finished game anyway. So this was your BattleTech episode today. If you like this video, don't forget to leave the like. If you are new to the channel, please consider subscribing. I'm doing more BattleTech in the future. And if you want to support me, then go down below to the description. There's the link to my Patreon page. There you can support me, get some bonus material and rewards out of that. And I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.